This is the Rashash. I told a lot of story about the Rashash, Rabbi Shalom Sharabi, the one and only. Basically, he's the rabbi that asked his student to stone him after he died, so he will have mavet beskila. And they disagreed to do it to their own teacher. What happened when they bury him, his body, it was some Muslim people who stoned them, and they left because they will be killed, the student, and his body fall down the mountain. And the students say, "Itkayma bakashato shel adonenu borenu Rabbi Shalom Sharabi." They say, our teacher wants something, and it happened the way it is. Why stoning? Because we know there is four type of death. There is sword, there's fire, there's hanging, there's stoning. And stoning can negate kulam. Meaning, person die by stoning, all the negativity a person ever did is gone away. But again, it's not in our level. The Rashash could do something called Kabbalah Mahasit, meaning there is different type of Kabbalah. There is intellectual Kabbalah, study Kabbalah, teaching Kabbalah. But to do Kabbalah Mahasit, meaning the person can do things that the five senses cannot capture. Rashash was one of those people. He came from Yemen and he was working on one thing, being nobody. How to achieve being nothing. So nobody knew in Jerusalem that he's very special. He was actually working as a sharat, as a janitor in the yeshiva. And nobody knew that at night when people have questions, they wrote questions on the notebook, he used to answer all the questions. Until the rabbi one time had a question and he answered his question. So the rabbi said, "Who is it that answer?" Wow, Chaim de la Rosa, I found him. I was looking for it. Wait, I will tell you another story. Just saw it, I never knew he's here. So the idea of the Rashash, so the rabbi said, "Who did it?" And nobody admitted. The rabbi closed the door, said, "I'm going to curse whoever is lied to me or didn't do it." And he still didn't say. In the end, make the long story short, they discovered it was him. So he asked him, "How come you didn't afraid to die? And better to discover yourself." He says, "It's better for a person to die than people know it's him, because then the ego go up." Can you imagine the level I'm talking about? You know, so that's the Rashash. So when we talk about the Rashash, we're talking about like a soul we cannot capture, we cannot really understand. But those of you who need a miracle in the body or in the soul or for somebody, like something they did Kabbalah Ma'asit, like a person want to fly or a person want to go different dimension, this is the Rashash. The Rashash one time saw somebody try to attack another human being in Jerusalem, and he basically looked at him, he said a name, there is a certain name, he said the name and he froze him. And the person couldn't move until his wife came to him and said to him, "Please, what have you done?" He said, "They tried to kill that guy. Can't do it." So okay, I will unfreeze him if he agree to do it. So that's story known to all the people, including Muslim and Jew, agree with that story. It's kind of very powerful story happening here in Jerusalem. So we're talking about the rabbi that want to be nobody. Nobody. How can you be a no? How do you do it? How do you do it that you are nothing? Well, you are somebody. You can do any Kabbalah, you can fly, you can do anything, and you still keep yourself small. And I'm not talking many years ago. This didn't happen many years ago, guys. This is like 200 years ago. It's not too long ago. This is like not too long ago. And to keep yourself in that level, you know? For that reason, this is all Sephardic rabbi. I mean, there is many of them here. Where they're standing there is the famous story that I usually don't like to tell about four rabbis who tried to bring the Messiah. He was the closest one. And I can't believe I'm actually here. I just found it. And they did something that... Wow, white pigeon. Wow, white pigeon in the middle of everything. My God, what's going on here today? So, I know we have to feed the body. I understand we're feeding the soul. We're going to feed the body in a second. So, this is another rabbi. And I'm going to go. It's not for everybody. It might be tough to climb downstairs. I'm going to the one and only that lived here 500 years ago. He was announced as the Messiah of Yosef. His name is Rabbi Chaim ben Atar, Or Chaim Bakadosh. Is famous for having the same soul as the Baal Shem Tov. The Baal Shem Tov carried the Nefesh, those of you who know Nefesh, the lowest level of the soul of David HaMelech, and he carried the Ruach of King David. Together they were supposed to bring the end of the Tikkun. We know what happened. They never met. Baal Shem Tov lost his mind on the way to Israel, and that's why he gets stuck in Istanbul. And Rabbi Chaim ben Attar made it here. And when he made it to Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, we're going to be there in Beron, he went and he crawled like a dog. And his 1,000 students tell him, Rabbi, why are you walking like this? Say, if you will see what I see, you'll be even ashamed to stand in this place. We don't see it. What is Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai? So that's where I'm going after this to Rabbi Chaim ben Attar.